Welcome back. It's a popular tradition in the metro area, Jazz in July, bringing live music to every part of the city, and it's all free of charge. Terry McElhon and John Krantz are here with the details, and thank you so much, both of you, for coming in today. Tell us a little bit, 30th anniversary, Terry. We were just talking about that. Wow.
We are so excited for our 30th anniversary this year. We are a free outdoor festival, two events throughout the month, and everything is family friendly, lots of activities with wonderful live jazz music. We're very proud of our 30th anniversary.
Who sponsors this? How did it all come together?
This is an entirely community event. We rely on community partners, neighborhood associations throughout the community who organize and put on the event, and what we have to offer is the wonderful music.
All right, and John, you've been a part of this, also on the board, but you're a musician too, so what does it mean for you?
It's, you know, Jazz in July is a wonderful thing because it's not only the music for people, but it's also a celebration of all these different communities. There's, I think, 23 different site locations, or 22 different site locations with 26 different bands playing. And at each location, it's a little mini festival with food vendors and drink vendors and children's activities. So there's more than just the jazz, but the level of musicianship with the jazz is remarkable.
And you've got to be exposing so many people of all ages to something that they may not have heard
of before.
Absolutely,
and there is something for everyone, because under the broad term of jazz, there's, you know, modern jazz and more retro jazz, and there's vocal jazz, and something for everyone.
How are you coping in the heat? Has that made any adjustment in your schedules?
We've had events like the Yankee Doodle Pops that the show goes on regardless of the temperature, and then for each of the concerts there is a plan for when there's excessive heat, and that information is available on the website. But we have wonderful alternate locations for rain or heat.
All right, and there is a change tonight, I understand.
Tonight it's the historic East Village is hosting the Jazz in July, and it is moved to Woolies, which is an indoor location with large seating capacity at 504 East Locust. Mm-hmm. And there are two bands playing starting at 6 o'clock, a quartet called Workshop. And at 7:45, the Paige Harpin Group takes the stage.
All right, and this runs through July 28th every night. John, when do you perform?
Oh, July 17th at the Waukee Triangle Park.
All right, it sounds wonderful. So everybody come out tonight, and it sounds like so much fun. Tomorrow night it's on the lawn at Roosevelt, and it's just a wonderful neighborhood get-together. For more information, you have a website.
JazzinJuly.org. It's a great resource. It has all the information that you need, all the locations, the sponsors, as well as, you said, the rain and the heat.
Sounds great.
Alternate locations.
Sounds good. Terry and John, thank you for
coming
in today.
Pleasure.
We appreciate it.
Thank you very much.
Let's go for 31, right? We're back with Stocks right after this.